Everyone, minnared. Welcome, Suda-san and his translator, Harris. Home run, yokuzo. Thank you very much for being here.
How's it going?
Hi, nice to meet you. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you. Thank you so much, you both, for being here.
Sorry.
No, it's okay.
Luke Cage.
Nice.
Oh,
yeah.
Luke Cage.
Great.
Oh my gosh. My first question for you, Suda-san. I mean, what has been the response to your statement that the series is ending?
まずは、シリーズノーモンヒルズシリーズがこれで終わるっていうことを発表してからの、そのユーザーたちからの反応ってどんなものでしょうか。
そうですね、皆さんツイッターで結構涙マークなんかあるじゃないですか、アイコンみたいなやつ、あれをすごく送ってくれて、トラビスと本当別れするのが寂しいっていうのと、ただトラビスが本当14年間ビデオゲームの中で活躍してくれてありがとうっていう、まあそういう、あったかい声ばかりで、ただもしいつかまた会えるなら、トラビスに会いたいっていう、本当にそういうメッセージをたくさん、受け取ってます、僕の方に。はい。
A lot of people have been sending over, emojis, like the crying face and, the little freaking out face and stuff. But, actually, I was kind of surprised to see that, the majority of people have been really supportive and said, thanks a lot for the past 14 years.if it's ever, assuming it's ever going to be possible again, I can't wait to see Travis again. I can't wait to hang out with Travis again. So, we've received a lot of really kind messages from everyone. And, the response has actually been really supportive and great so far.
Aww.
Awesome. Now, the character, Travis, he's been so loved for so long. A lot of people have been asking,Is this the first game that they've come out with? We let them know that there's a 3 involved in it. Is it okay for them to dive in now? Or should they play it from the beginning to the end? How accessible is it?
Travis っていうのはもう結構長い間、ずっと、まあ、ゲームに登場していると思うんですけど、ノーマルヒローズ思いっきり初めてっていうユーザーに対して、まあ、3から全然、まあ、突然入っちゃってもいいよっていう感じなのか、それがもうやっぱり一番最初からやってみないとなかなかわからないっていう感じなのか、そこら辺はどうでしょうか。
今回この3から入ってるファンが結構多いんですね。特に多分若いゲーマーの人たちっていうのは1と2なかなか遊び機会がなくて、今まあスイッチで発売してるんですけども、新作タイトルっていうことで3から入ってるんですけども、本当にポジティブな反応がすごく多くて、カラフルでクリエイティブで本当見たことないようなゲームっていう評判をすごくもらってるので、まあ本当構図がトラビス対、本当サノスみたいなすげえやばいやつっていうこの構図がですね、本当にロッキー3の、クレバー対ロッキーバルボア、まあこの戦いに非常に近いので、本当に皆さん分かりやすい図式の多分戦いになっているので、スッとこの3の世界に入れると思います。
Actually, I found that a lot of the people who've been sending messages saying, hey, this is a great game, are actually fans who got into the game for the first time from No More Heroes 3. Obviously, there's a lot of backstory involved and everything, so it would be great to, start from the beginning. But as far as 3 goes, as a standalone game, it's got a similar structure and kind of a similar flavor to, for example, Rocky 3, where, you've got Travis, the main character, who's got to go up this, he's got to go up against this Thanos-style, bad guy, and just completely overwhelming, badass dude, And it really does seem to do a pretty good job just as a standalone game. Lots of messages I've got have said, this is really colorful, it's really creative, there's a lot of stuff in this game I've never seen before. So I feel that, I can say with confidence that you can pretty much just start out with No More Heroes 3 without being too lost and be able to have a great time.
Wow.
Well, I'm going to just follow up real quick because chat is going wild. They're so happy to have Suda-san here. You're known for a very creative and explorative style. Is there any chance in the future that we can see you work on a Deadpool game? That was from chat.
チャットに入ってきた質問なんですが、スダさんのゲームって確かにすごくこうクリエイティブで、なかなか他で見ることのないようなゲームばっかりなんですけど、 将来的に、
so はい、
鈴木さんが、はい、あのデッドプールのゲームにこう関わるっていう可能性はありますでしょうか。
そうですね、この間もちょっとインタビューでそういう話をして、まあ、やっぱりマーベルのタイトルは一回ちょっと作りたいなと思ってて、まあ、でもこれ本当も多分時効になってると思うんですけども、今から10年前くらいですかね、アクティビジョンからあのデッドプール作らないかって企画話が一回来たことあって、で、まあ、僕ら企画を出して、でその時からデッドプールの存在を知ってたんですね。でまだまだこの映画になる前の時代だなんですけども、でその時からまあちょっとデッドプールというものはずっと頭に残ってるので、そうですね、デッドプールもしくはベノム、このどちらかのゲームを作りたいなっていうのと、あと僕個人的にあのマーベルのキャラクターでシャッタースターっていうキャラクターが大好きなんですよ。こうシャッタースターをビデオゲームのスターにするような、なんかそんなゲームを作りたいなと思ってます。はい、ぜひあのマーベルの方、よろしくお願いします。
I've actually really wanted to work on some sort of Marvel game for a long time now. And I'm pretty sure that, you know, this offer is no longer on the table, but about 10 years ago, I was actually contacted by Activision, and they asked if I wanted to make a Deadpool game. At the time, I was familiar with Deadpool, but this was before, you know, like the Ryan Reynolds movies and everything. But yeah, I've always actually been a fan of Deadpool and thought that would be really cool to be able to work on a Deadpool game. And so at the time, you know, I sent over a couple ideas. Not really sure what happened with that, but you know, obviously it didn't work out. But at some point, yeah, it would be really great to be able to make some sort of Marvel game. I'd actually really like to work on a Deadpool game or maybe even a Venom game. And personally, there's a Marvel hero named Shutterstar, who I think is really cool. And I'd really like to work on that sort of game as well. So if there's anyone from Marvel out there listening, hit me up.
Yes, I'm here for that. That sounds incredible. I got so excited about it. Now, I would also love to know, you know, for huge fans of the series, I mean, this has been, you know, 14 years in the making, as you were saying. To you, what makes No Heroes 3 special to you?
No More Heroes 3 はもう14年も前から始まったシリーズでして、で、まあ、大ファンは結構多いと思うんですけど、みんなすごく、まあ、待ちに待ってたと思うんですけど、須田さん自身からしたら、はい、そのノーマーヒーローズ3っていうのがもう本当に、まあ、これが特別なゲームなんだって思える点っていうのはどういうところでしょうか。
一番はやっぱりトラビスっていうキャラクターがなんか自分のそば周辺にいる感じがするんですよね。トラビスの匂いがするというか、ノーマーヒーローズ2を作った後もそうなんですけども、何かトラビスの気配を感じて、またなんかトラビスの物語を書きたいなって思う瞬間がたまにすごくあって、あと僕自身もトラビスって今何やってんだろうなっていう、本当にリアルタイムにトラビスは年を取ってるっていう僕自身もイメージ持ってるので、何か一緒に成長していく存在ではあるんですよね。でやっぱりスイッチの発表があった時に見せて、任天堂さんに見せてもらった時に、トラビスがなんか今ここが復活のタイミングなんじゃないかみたいな、またもう一回俺たちで暴れようぜみたいな、なんかそんな声が聞こえたんですよね。なんかね、やっぱり自分の中にトラビスがこう同化してるような、住んでるような、なんかやっぱそういう存在でありますし、ノーマーヒローズというタイトルはやっぱ自分の中にそのぐらいこう埋め込まれたシリーズになってると思います。
Actually, I felt something similar while I was working on and just after I finished No More Heroes 2 as well. But the character of Travis himself, ever since working on No More Heroes 2, I've always sort of felt that he was sort of like somewhere in the vicinity, you know, like it's almost like I could smell him, like he's right there, like really close by somewhere. And in the No More Heroes series, I actually, at least in my head, Travis has been aging basically in real time, like along with, you know, with me and the players, everybody else. So I've always kind of had this feeling that Travis is sort of, you know, growing and developing and evolving, like along with me and along with everyone. And, you know, every once in a while, I kind of get this idea, I wonder what Travis is doing right now. Like, where would Travis be right now? What would he be doing? Who would he be with? You know? And a few years ago, when the people in Nintendo showed me the Switch for the first time, something just kind of clicked in my head. And I thought, you know what? I think this might be some kind of sign. I think it might be just about time to bring Travis back, you know? And so, yeah, Travis has always just been this, you know, I mean, the series in general too, but Travis in particular has always just been this really sort of special, this really sort of special thing to me. Again, I can always sort of feel him like right there. It's like he's always just really close by, you know? And this is sort of the epitome of that. So that's kind of what makes the series in general, but this game in particular special to me.
That's beautiful. Wow. Oh my God.
I love it. I love it. I love the connection. And so many people talk about the character in the game so much. Yeah. Thank you so much. Arigato. When it comes to... Oh, yeah.
Now, we have a chat question coming in from Dream Bomb. Hope I said your name right. They would like to know, should we expect Suda to remain a director for future Grasshopper games or be more of a producer?
チャットからのご質問なんですが、須田さんはどちらかと言いますと、はい、そのグラスホッパーゲームにおいて、ディレクター的な役割を務められるのでしょうか、はい、それかどちらかって言ったら、あのここからは、まあ、もうちょっとこうプロデューサー寄り的な、はい、役割でしょうか。
そうですね、ちょっとメガネをするとプロデューサーっぽいんですけども、ただもうこれからはもうディレクターです。あのトラビススラクサーゲームからディレクター復帰しまして、まあ、十何年ぶりかな、やっぱり現場に戻って若いスタッフとも一緒に仕事をして、まあ、まだクラスオッパー小さなチームなんですけども、トラビス・アクサ・アゲン、それからノーマン・ヒローズ3と連続で、まあ、約5年間くらいかな、今のチームでものを作ってるんですけども、やっぱり僕が現場に入ってみんなと同じ空気を吸って、まあ、今ちょっとリモートなので、ね、同じ空気は吸えないんですけども、やっぱり近い距離感で仕事をして、これまで あまり、ね、言葉交わすことなかった、本当、若いスタッフとも直接指示を出したりとか、僕自身のゲームの吸い方みたいなものを若いスタッフとこうね、あの近くで感じてもらって、やっぱり僕自身やっぱりゲームの現場で育った人間なので、やはりこれからもプロデューサー的な立場っていうのはもちろん あるとは思うんですけども、僕自身の中心はもうディレクターですね。おそらくもう、死ぬまで、ディレクターでやっていくつもりです。本当にこの仕事って年を取っても年老いても多分できる仕事だと思ってるので、本当に僕が死ぬときはこうパソコンの前でシナリオを書いてる最中にガクッと死んでいく、それが僕の夢だったりしますかね。死に方として、はい、まあ、そのぐらい現場にこだわってこれからやっていって、まあ、自分のディレクション作品というものを本当一本でも多く世に残していきたいなというのが僕自身の、はい、目標でもあり、ライフワークですね。
Well, as I said earlier, you know, when I put those glasses on, I become a bit more producer-ish.But to be honest, from here on out, yeah, I'm basically going to be a director. I kind of got back, got back in the director seat from Travis Strikes Again. And since we started working on Travis Strikes Again, it's been about 5 years altogether at this point. And since that point, I really sort of realized, or like re-remembered, I guess you could say, how much I just love being down in the in the stuff, you know, with the actual team, you know, working on the game with the actual programmers and the artists and everything, and you know, giving directions directly to like the younger staff, and you know, talking to like the veteran staff and everything, you know, really being down there and you know, breathing the same air. I mean, right now, you know, with the whole pandemic and everything, we're not exactly breathing the same air because working remotely, but you know, really working together with everyone, like really directly and knowing exactly what's going on. The team we've got at Grasshopper right now, it's still a pretty small team, but it's an awesome team. I love working with this team. And to be honest, I'm pretty sure that from now until I die, I'm going to be a director for the rest of my life. It sounds kind of weird, but I've always kind of had this dream of like when I die, I'm going to be sitting there typing at the computer, you know, directing something, and then just kind of keel over dead, you know. That's how I'd like to go. Right. So I'd like to announce here now that I'm going to be a director for the rest of my life.
You heard it first, everybody. You're on Twitch Gaming. Suda San is in it for life, literally. Love it. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. So there's some great things within the game that people may not know if they just kind of breeze through the game or casually play it. Could you please tease a little bit of something, like maybe a hidden boss on a bike mission?
確かにノーマンヒルズ3ってこうカジュアル的な感じでこう、はい、なんとなく遊んでいくと あのなかなか気づかない、なかなか見つからない、こうちょっとこう言うたら隠れ要素的なものが、まあ、いろいろ含まれてるかと思うんですけど、はいはいはい、あの例えばその隠れボスとか、はいはい、何かあのこういうのもあるよってこう匂わせていただけるようなコメントはしていただけないでしょうか。
そうですね、もちろんランキング戦がメインなんですよね。あの皆さん、まあ、遊んでもらった方は分かると思うんですけど、トラビスっていうのが銀河系ランキングの10位に認定されて、ある敵とボスと戦ってミスターブラックホールと倒すとランキング10位に認定されて、それでまあ10位から1位まで駆け上がっていくんですけども、その中で戦うべきあの指定試合とボスファイトがあるんですけども、それ以外にもまあ様々なミッションが、防衛戦だったりとか、あとボランティアミッション、まあトラビスはボランティアをすることで経験値を稼いだりとか、街のために自分自身身を尽くすという、あの、まあ、それを積み重ねていってどんどんステップ進んです。ただ寄らなくてもクリアできるんですね。ただその今言ったように隠し要素がありまして、一つなかなか皆さん見つけられないのが、バイクバトル、バイクミッションというのがあります。でバイクミッション、あの街のあちこちに点在してるんですけども、まず全部クリアするとバイクミッションのボスファイトが登場します。これがノーマヒロズ2に登場したリュウジというキャラクター、あのトラビスのバイクとリュウジのバイクでバイク戦をするんですけども、これの、倒した、リュウジのお兄ちゃんが今度登場しまして、まあ、すごいモンスターマシンがあるんですけども、ちょっと後で画像用意します。あのこのリュウジとですね戦うボスファイトが実は隠れてます。これなかなかね皆さん見つからないと思うんですけども、これはぜひ皆さん、あのぜひ見つけて竜一を倒してください。竜一戦、あのかなり面白くできてますんで、はい、要チェックです。
Yeah, basically as you said, there's a lot of、sort of hidden elements and just, you know, kind of semi-hidden stuff in No More Heroes 3.As you know, most people who played the game probably know, you know, the main character is Travis, and I guess the main gist of the game is you go through these ranked battles with these different bosses. Travis starts out, you know, at number 10, fights a guy named Mr. Black Hole, and from then on, you know, he joins the rankings and has to fight his way up through number 1. If you just kind of wanted to breeze through the game and just, you know, start it up, do the bare minimum, fight through the boss fights, beat the boss, and clear the game, you can do that.But again, there really are a lot of sort of hidden and sort of semi-hidden elements in the game. Some of those elements are directly related to the various side missions. For example, there's defense missions. I'm going to touch on that one second.
Yeah, I'm here for that.
there's so cool. The defense missions, the bike missions, the volunteer missions, stuff like that. Travis doesn't have to do all these missions.But honestly, I really recommend that everyone goes through the various side missions as well, because there's a lot of stuff in there that you're probably going to miss otherwise. The first one that comes to mind is the bike missions. People who have played No More Heroes 2 might remember this, but in...
what are you, 7th of the year?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, behind the scenes content. Okay. I like it.
いや今倒した、隠そう隠そう、そうこういう感じで、ごめんね、ハリスごめんね、ハリスソーレ
あ、いやいや、大丈夫
大丈夫大丈夫
so, as players from No More Heroes 2 may remember, there was a boss in No More Heroes 2 named Ryuji. And, well, basically to simplify things, in No More Heroes 3, if you work your way through the bike missions, Ryuji's older brother, Ryuichi, appears as a hidden bossAnd there's basically a completely hidden boss fight with this guy. Not to give away too much, but I mean, as you saw just now in the video, this guy just has an absolutely badass motorcycle. And the boss fight is really, really well done. So even if you decide to skip over all the rest of the volunteer missions and the side stuff, I'd really appreciate it if fans of the series would go through at least the bike missions and take on the Ryuichi boss fight, because it's really awesome, and I got a lot of confidence in this one.
Nice. I love it. As the chat says, we love the passion, and they love everything that Suda-san and the studio is doing. Now, I have to ask a special personal question. Is there any way we'll be able to see a No More Heroes anime or live action?
Ooh.
さっきチャットから入ってきたんですけど、いや、須田さんのこの情報がもう大好きですっていうのがあったんですけど、 あの確かにあの自分もそう思ったということです。またちょっと個人的にどうしても聞きたい質問がありますが、はい、将来的にそのノーマンヒーローズの、アニメ版とか実写版とかそれが実現するっていう可能性はありますでしょうか。
これまで結構いくつか話も本当にあのノーマンヒーローズたくさんもらって実現しかけたこともあったりとか、あのパイロット版まで作ったことも実はあったりとかしたんですけども、まだ皆さんに見せるまでに至ってないっていうのが現在の状況ですね。はい、最近もメールで一つ来ましたね、映画化に対して興味があるっていう、はい、あのメールもいただいたりとかしていて、あの本当にいつか実現できるといいなとは思ってるんですけども、ただやっぱり、本当に何か映像化するんだったら僕のやっぱ好きな監督さんとかクリエイターの皆さんにやってほしいので、うん、やっぱ希望としてはノーマンヒーローズ3の中でも言ってますけども、三池監督、高橋三池監督、もしくはやっぱりジェームズ・ガンに撮ってほしいなっていう気持ちはありますね。やっぱりもう一度コラボするんだったら僕のゲームとジェームズ・ガンが本来映画監督として一緒にこうコラボできたら最高なのでまあ本当にそういう日が来たらもう最高なんですけども、はい、あのそういう贅沢な形でノーマンヒーローズの映像化っていうものは、期待したいなと思ってますし、いつかできればいいなと思ってます。
はい。A lot of people probably don't know this, but over the years, I've actually been approached by several people and several companies saying, hey, we want to make a, you know, some sort of No More Heroes feature, you know?There's not a whole lot of details that I can discuss, right now, but, at one point, we may or may not have actually gone as far as,producing a pilot for a No More Heroes show. Unfortunately, you know, as you know, it never really came to fruition. But the thing is, one day, if possible, I would love to see some sort of No More Heroes, you know, a live action feature, like an anime, something like that. But the thing is, if we're going to do it, then I would really love to do it with somebody with whom I would actually, or somebody to whom I would actually want to entrust my characters, my game. For example, this comes up in No More Heroes 3 itself, actually, a few times, but Takashi Miike, the Japanese director, that's one dude that I'd love to work with. Another option is I would love to have James Gunn do the No More Heroes movie. You know, like my game and my story, my characters in the hands of somebody like James Gunn, honestly, that would just be awesome. So, you know, obviously I can't see anything concrete right now, but at some point in the future, personally, I too would be really happy if you know, some sort of No More Heroes feature could become a reality. And I definitely won't say that it's never going to be a thing. So, yeah, hopefully everyone else can keep their expectations up just like I am.
Yes.
Fingers crossed. That sounds incredible. Oh my gosh. So and Aaron, I want to take the time to thank you both for speaking with us. I know it is super late where you are in the world, but before you go, where can fans find out more information about the development of the studio and the game? And also, is there a place for some merch? I see some really cool t-shirts behind you. Mm-hmm. Maybe we can drop a link, perhaps.
今日はまずあの来ていただいてありがとうございました。はい、確かにあの日本ではものすごく時間が遅いと思います がありがとうございました。また、そうお別れする前にどうしてもちょっと聞きたいんですけど、はい、あの、はい、ファンの方はNo More Heroesの開発とか、そのシリーズ自体に関する情報とか、またグラスホッパーに関する情報とかってどこかでこう調べたりとかいろいろこう読んだり。することができるサイトとかってありますでしょうか。また、確かに須田さんの後ろの方に素敵な T シャツがいくつか並んでるんですけど、はい、こういう商品とかも購入できるところってありませんでしょうか。
そうですね、まずグラスホッパーの情報は一番の面はもうツイッターなんですね。ツイッターのグラスホッパーの、英語のEN の公式、もしくはまあ僕のツイッターでもいいんですけど、あとノーマンヒーローズ3の公式ツイッターも開設したので、ぜひこの3つをチェックしてもらえると新しい情報が出ます。まあ、特にあのノーマンヒーローズ3に関してはノーマンヒーローズ3の公式ツイッターぜひチェックしてください。はい、であとは T シャツですね。 T シャツはね、はい、これあの全部うちの会社で作ったんですけども、オフィシャルで販売してないんですよ。ただあのこの間ネットで調べたらレッドリボンっていうサイトかな、 あの勝手に作ってる T シャツがいっぱいあるので、この辺大体ね商品誰かが作ってます。レッドリボンで買えばいいんじゃないかなと思ってて、はい。ジムズ知ってる？レッドリボン。あ、ジムズじゃない、ハリス。レッドリボンって知ってる？
もういいですよ。いや、あ、分からないですよ。サイト名
あ、本当に？
あげちゃったんですか？
いいんじゃない？か、あの皆さん多分知ってると思うんだけど、そうそうそう。なんかそこでは勝手に作られてます。はい、この辺。
あ、分かりました。
はい。
Yeah, as far as information about Grasshopper, the studio and the game itself goes, there are three Twitter feeds that I'd like everyone to check. There's the Grasshopper Manufacturer English Twitter feed. I believe it's Grasshopper with just EN tacked on at the end. There's also my own personal Twitter feed, and then there's the official No More Heroes 3 Twitter feed as well. As far as stuff for the game goes, obviously the No More Heroes 3 Twitter feed would probably be best. As far as the shirts go, actually the shirts that you see behind me, these were shirts that were that we actually made at Grasshopper, and we're not really selling officially. Little side note, as interpreter, I got one of the ones on the far right and I'm super stoked about it, but they're not actually available for sale online or anything from us. But I'm not sure if it's actually okay to bring this up, but there's a site, I believe it's called Red Ribbon, that they appear to be making and selling these shirts just on their own without permission. So since we're not doing it, if anybody out there wants a shirt, check out Red Ribbon. They got them there.
There you go. Harris said, I got my shirt. I'm good.
Just rub it in. All right. Let's see what you're doing here.
Oh, my God. Thank you both so much for taking this time to speak with us. We appreciate you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you so much. Thank you. ありがとう。いや、本当にありがとう。番組に呼んでもらって嬉しいです。ありがとう。
Thanks a lot for having us on. We're super happy to be able to talk to you guys. Thanks a lot.
Yes. That was so cool. What a legend. You know, the chat was like already saying it, and I agree so much. The interviews that I love to do are like developers that are super passionate about the work that they're putting out. And you can tell, I mean, he said he was calling it. I mean, I hope he doesn't die by the keyboard, you know, directing. But hey, that passion was there and I appreciate it. So yeah, that was super exciting. I love that.
Cool. It was really awesome. And then hearing about, you know, the possible maybe anime live action collaboration we may see in the future. Fingers crossed, everybody keep your fingers crossed.